I can't control what I inherit. You can control what you do with it. I know,
which is exactly what I'm considering.
For her own but the madam's always considering.
Well, like one, it is not one thing,
it's another.
As long as they pay.
Let me know when you don't hear side.
What was that about?
She spat in my face. Or might as well have. Called me a whoremonger and a witless hack. Can you imagine? Wit is my forte.
Gotta say, Priscilla's really growing on me.
Save it.
And why don't you save your pouting? Prove to her she's wrong.
Exactly what I plan to do. I've always dreamed of having my own cabaret. A bit of paint and plaster, and this place will do splendidly. Just one hitch. I need coin. So, if you happen to get a break between drowners and ecumajigs, maybe you can help an old friend out.
Where do you get this cabaret idea?
It's been a dream for years. Ever since we went to see one in Oxford. Remember? The dancer hanging from the chandelier? And once she was completely downside up, she called you over and...
I remember.
How could you forget? And this place will be even better, I promise. That is, of course, if I can scrounge together the funds for some remodeling.
How much do you need? Maybe I can lend you the coin.
Thank you, Geralt, but I refuse to take a single crown from you. You know what they say. Fastest way to lose a friend's to loan him some coin. But a favor? That's different.
What kind of favor?
I dated this girl once, Sophronia. That's a name if you can believe it. Has a merchant for a father, importer of spices from Zeracania. And Daddy Dear would never refuse his daughter Dear a thing. We can borrow the coin from her.
Name rings a bell. Isn't this the woman you abandoned without saying a word? Stepped out for a bottle of wine, never to return?
You know, I bought that wine for a reason.
Long time ago, that.
Been away a while, sure. Which is why I need to draw on your authority. You've got some, you know, no matter what you might think.
Fine, tell me what you want. Got a feeling you've a plan all cooked up.
Sophronia could still be holding a grudge after our unfortunate parting. But with a touch of help from you, I know she'll forgive me. And then give me that loan.
What's this help entail?
First of all, we need to borrow a dull sword from Madame Irina, one of her props. You know, the kind they use during performances? Get that, then meet me outside Sophronia's house.
Let's say I agree and go see Madame Irina. What'll you be doing in the meantime?
Something I have to finish. But I promise I'll do it before you come back with the sword. Then I'll tell you the rest.
Fine, but...
Geralt, the only buts in this plan will be the ones filling my seats. It'll work, you'll see. Get the sword from Madame Irina and meet me outside Sophronia's at sunset. Ah, finally made it. Listen, here's the plan. Sophronia loves adventure-filled romance novels. I can be a hero in her eyes, if I can just save her from a bandit. I'll have her eating out of my hand, and there's no way she'll begrudge me that loan.
Want me to be the bandit?
Knew you'd see the sense in it right away.
Are you serious? That's your brilliant plan?
I never called it brilliant, but any kind of plan is better than none. Written your lines already.
You've written what?
So you know what to say during the performance. Here, Andromask, put it on. Sophronia can't recognize you.
But...
No time. Sophronia's coming. Stick to the plan. We'll meet at the Rosemary in the morning.
Stop right there.
What is this? Help! Save me!
tremble, flaxen-haired wench. Bow before the Prince of Thieves.
Not so fast. Drop your sword, scoundrel. This is your first and last warning.
Dandelion!
'Tis I, though the scum of the city call me the Crimson Avenger.
No, not the Crimson Avenger.
Silence, vermin! You shall regret the day you were born.
Dandelion! Crimson Avenger!
You're better than I thought.
Guards!
God.
Just wait. They'll drag you away in shackles. Run, good folk! We've a madman!
Run, Dandelion! Crimson Avenger!
The Crimson Avenger triumphs again.
My hair! Are you well?
One blow struck true. Another scar from my collection.
Come inside. I shall bandage you up. Be gone, vile bandit, or the Crimson Avenger will beat you senseless!
Cheap wine.
What's the ruckus about?
Polly and her half-brained fiancé. They're fighting. She's the only one in this town who knows anything about choreography, and that lummox won't let her work for me. Hold on. What are you doing here? We were gonna meet at the Rosemary.
We were, but you didn't show. Priscilla started to worry, so I came to see how you were doing.
Priscilla started worrying about me? That's so nice!
Less for her than for you, I'm sure. So let's get back.
Did you not hear what's going on in there? We've gotta help Polly. Why do beautiful women always end up with such dicks?
No idea. Stand back. I'll break the door down.
Wait! Do we have to destroy her house? She keeps a spare key around here somewhere.
How would you know she keeps a spare key around here?
It's not as if we started working together yesterday. Before Polly joined forces with Hubio...
You'd visit her? Often?
I'd hide out here while Priscilla and Polly rehearsed at the Rosemary in Time. They worked on the dance numbers I composed.
So, Polly's not one of your...
I never mix business and pleasure.
The one exception being Priscilla.
Who you were just saying is worried about us. So enough of the chatter, and start looking.
Fine. Let's find the key.
Damn it.
Not here.
Now where would she leave?
The key.
What the devil's this? Get out of my house!
Watch it, and leave the woman alone.
What the... She's my betrothed!
But I'm not your property!
I love her! I'll not let her sway her ass in his brothel!
Whoa, slow down there a minute. This is clearly one gigantic misunderstanding. One I can clear up in the blink of an eye.
Shove your excuses up your ass! Sod off, or I'll split your skull!
My friend asked you nicely, so please be courteous in return and hear him out, or we'll settle this another way.
All right. Talk.
Hubio, right? Polly's told me so much about you. She said you're erudite and have an open mind.
You said that? Well, there's a truth to it. My mind's the open salt. But its open-saltedness ends when my betrothed starts wagging her ass around brothels. Get out of here, both of yous. Polly's not going anywhere.
Let him finish. There's no brothel involved.
You see, friend, Geralt just hit the nail on the head. For what you have there is the old publicity placard.
Old?
Very. From a time when my establishment was under different management. I, however, would never let any indecency take place in my cabaret. My very reputation precludes it.
So, what's all this about?
Your betrothed is a first-class artiste, and I want to offer her a position worthy of her talents. She's to be my choreographer, and that in turn means she'll receive a share of the proceeds from every performance she choreographs.
You mean to say, coin?
And fame. No flirting required. You have my word.
Suppose, in that case...
I knew you'd agree.
It's settled then. See you at the Rosemary, Polly.
Well, I'm off.
I'll catch up to you. Whew. Never expected that to go so well.
You handled it well, Dandelion. Man was putty in your hands once you called him erudite.
In negotiation, as in combat, the key is to find your opponent's weak spot and exploit it to the hilt.
So, time to head back?
I've still got to stop by Rotlix. Commissioned some new placards from him a while ago, but Hubio came across the old version. Plowing artists got some serious explaining to do.
Who's Rotlick?
Never heard of him? Hank Rotlick, famous portrait artist?
Commissioned a portrait artist to paint your placards?
Henry's an old friend, needed the coin. And I decided we needed new placards to promote the opening performance. Seats won't fill themselves, you know.
I'll go see Rotlick. You head back to the Rosemary, or Priscilla will have my head.
Really? You'd go?
No, said that for the hell of it. Tell me where he lives.
Portside.
See you soon. Looking for Rotlick.
You ain't alone. Damn halfling's in debt to half the city. But I'm here to scrape mine before the carcass is picked clean.
There's not enough for everyone, so bugger off. Feeding time's first come, first served.
You're not gonna rob him.
Strange, don't recall asking your permission. Get him, Fred!
Come on, come closer.
Quit this, mutant! Tell me what you want. Damn it!
Placards.
There ain't no plowing placards here.
And Rotlick, where's he?
Same place as always. Vehicle Bud Estate. Losing his last crowns at the races.
See? Wasn't that easy? Could have said so right away.
Rotlick, artist, painter, debtor, and martyr to my art. At your service.
Dandelion sent me.
Oh, yes. I tell him his placards are done and safely hidden away. Yet, alas, I cannot fetch them. As a group of angry creditors has seized my home.
Think I might have run into one of them.
Then you know my predicament. Now Count de Louverton has offered me the chance to win it all back. I'm to wager on a race.
Generous. Not just anybody could afford to do that.
De Louverton is not just anybody. He's Duke Sam's youngest son. Sam of the well-known family of gem dealers. One debt more or less makes little difference to him.
What's there to worry about? This is your chance to settle up, get a clean slate.
We've had a spell of bad luck lately. Should I agree to de Louverton's offer and lose, I shall be in bondage to him for all time.
Listen, all I really want are the placards. Tell me where you tucked them away and I'll be out of your hair.
Forgive me, I cannot. I hid them with family heirlooms that would work those barbarians lurking outside my home into a slavering froth.
Then go fetch them yourself. I'll wait here.
If I show my face there without coin, they'll beat me to a pulp. I must win back my debt somehow, else I'll never return home.
Let me pay off your debt. No strings attached.
Thank you. I never expected this. May I ask to what I owe this generosity?
Let's just say I like to do a good deed from time to time. Can we get those placards now?
I'll bring them to the Rosemary in time, just as soon as I settle my obligations.
Fine. See you there.
The piece is sad, melancholy. It needs a minor key.
But I wanted to.
To ruin everything. We'll start in E minor.
Well, well. See, the crew's been hard at work. Not bad.
No. No, not all. But I'd imagine something more, you know, more theatrical.
Don't you like it? But I thought a boudoir would be right in line with your tastes.
Oh. You chose it. Well, I'm not saying it's bad, just different. Not exactly what I'd envisaged. You know, now that I think about it, you're absolutely right. A boudoir is the perfect setting for a cabaret. What about Rotlick? Did you get the placards?
Rotlick said he'd bring them on his own. Should be here soon.
Great. The best way I can think of to promote the chameleon.
Never mentioned wanting to change the name.
Rosemary and Thyme wasn't all bad, but it conjured images of Temerian cuisine served by waitresses in peasant garb. Chameleon's a lot better for a cabaret, apart from which it emphasizes that the place has undergone a transformation. Just a better ring to it all round.
What about choreography? Prepared anything special for the opening?
We haven't. But Polly has. She's priceless. Came in and brought the girls in line before I could say knickers. Premier will have the audience on their feet, on their knees, both at the same time.
Guess everything's ready. So when's the opening?
Soon. We start our dress rehearsal in an hour. I just need to nip back home for my dress.
Thanks for everything.
Don't mention it.
Seems my cabaret dreams are about to come true. So, around to celebrate? I'm buying.
Why not?
That's my boy. The foreman mentioned he saw you and Priscilla talking.
He's all right.
And she say anything about me?
Said something that made me think she's not entirely normal.
What?
That you're responsible, got your feet planted firmly on the ground.
You're pulling my leg.
Not this time. One thing's eating me. How do you manage to get the loan from Sophronia?
Oh, it wasn't easy. She got so excited about our performance, I had to read to her for 4 hours. 4 hours from the cloak and the dagger.
You mean you didn't?
Are you crazy? Who do you think I am? She's late, of course. She knew how important this night was to me.
Of course she did. Probably just making herself gorgeous. Takes time away.
So it's true. A woman's vanity knows no bounds.
Master Dandelion! Priscilla, she's...
What? Speak, man.
She's badly, been attacked. They took her to Volmerius Hospital.
Attacked? She's hurt? Geralt, come with me, please.
Of course, let's go.
Gods. Priscilla. Is she gonna live?
I'd say that's certain. Her condition's critical but stable. Beg your pardon, but you are a relative?
Relative? No, a friend. A very close friend.
Dandelion, correct? She uttered the name in her few moments of lucidity. I am Joachim von Gratz, head of surgery. Until recently, a lecturer at Oxenfurt Academy.
Enough of the courtesies. What are her injuries, besides her eye?
A concussion, cranial swelling, incision into her larynx, and scalding inside the throat and esophagus. Clearly someone forced her to imbibe a caustic fluid.
So this was no ordinary attack, no robbery.
Clearly not. It was the act of a demented mind, and not its first.
How can you know that?
I've seen wounds like this. They're not the kind one would forget, don't you agree? In fact, just this week, a corpse turned up in the morgue with similar injuries. And no heart.
No heart? You mean that might have happened to Priscilla? Is someone looking into this?
This is Novigrad. Only the innocent burn here.
Geralt, I know I owe you 100 times over, but I need to ask you another favor. Find the bastard who did this. Find him. And kill him.
Don't need any convincing. Come on, Dandelion. Let's think about what we can do.
I would suggest examining the previous victim's corpse. It has yet to be autopsied. Doing so could very well provide some clues. No need to look astonished, gentlemen. As a surgeon, I know the importance of preventive medicine. Rather than wait for this maniac to strike again, I'd prefer to excise him. Not unlike a tumor.
Great analogy, but this tumor's not gonna sit there, wait to be excised. Appreciate the help, but I doubt you know what you're getting yourself into.
I know perfectly well, and I assure you I can take care of myself.
Easy assurance to make, harder to back up, especially if you've spent your whole life wielding a scalpel, not a sword.
Look at this scar. Don't be shy. Any idea what leaves such a mark?
A flail. Morning Star, maybe.
What do you think? A blow sustained at the operating table? No? Let me repeat. I know what I'm doing, and I wish to help.
Think they'll let me into the morgue?
By the main entrance, certainly not. But you can also get inside through the sewers.
The sewers? Travel them often, Doctor?
As often as required for, the pursuit of preventive medicine.
Alternative treatments. Aggressive ones, I'm guessing. Interesting.
We can discuss this en route. Are you ready?
Mm-hmm. Ready and intrigued. I'll get whoever did this, Dandelion. Even if it's Hierarch Hemelfart himself.
Thanks.
You lead.
So, Vicky with sap. Must be our dwarf.
Excellent. I trust you don't grow weak in the knees at the sight of blood?
Not a bit. Start the autopsy.
Where?
Let's look at his head. Hair smells like it's burnt, like he was in a fire.
Notice anything else? That his eyes have been scooped out, for instance?
Those burn marks I see in his eye sockets.
Yes, and some gray dust. Ash, it seems. Very fine.
Murderer gouged out his eyes, then put burning coals in the sockets.
So it seems. Looking at the wounds, it appears our woodcarver was still alive when it happened.
Let's examine the mouth. Burns, blisters.
Just like Priscilla's.
See this? Incision made into the voice box.
Indeed, so thin as to be nearly unnoticeable.
A small, extremely sharp instrument. Scalpel.
And but why? The wound is too small to bleed, and there are signs of swelling. The murderer... I believe he performed a tracheotomy, so the victim wouldn't die too soon.
Let's look at his head.
Notice anything else?
Let's examine his torso.
What have we here? Deep wound on the left side of his rib cage, and a scar the length of his stomach.